birthday to everyone who is not on that list but is celebrating. Any other announcements for the good and the glory of God? Yes, go ahead, Mary. You want to come over here?
Yes.
She wanted to startle us.
I got everyone's attention. I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about open and affirming. All is welcome is not enough. I'd like to speak to you a little bit about starting a study group, open and affirming. Our congregation is very progressive in the way that we support and help each other and our community and our families just as Jesus has taught us. I'd like to gather together a group of members, consistory, and pastor to form a study group. And this group will study and pray as we understand the love that Jesus and our Bible has taught us. It'll help us to experience the fullness in the body of Christ, not to divide us one against another. Open and affirming is our justice commitment to all people, LGBTQ, sexual orientations, people of all nations, races, cultures, and ages. Everyone of God, faith, and our faith in our community is welcome and accepted without any exceptions. Love is love. I have a clipboard in the back that I welcome any of you who would like to join this study group to sign. Please put your email address and your phone number. Thank you.
Thank you, Mary. And just for a reminder, I think we are open and reaffirming. We do have same gender marriages in our church that are members. And please put your hand out to them and welcome them as well as welcoming anybody else. I appreciate your understanding on this. Anything else to the glory of God?
I have a request. The mission team is looking for people who
would be willing to help with, could we pipe me down just a little bit? I don't know if Ricky Spears ever says that or not, and could you flip the screen to the Heidelberg announcement, please?
That's on the free screen.
On the free screen.
We all have the free screen.
So, okay, I'm having a COVID moment.
It's Monday.
It's Monday? Oh, no, I was going to say it's Sunday. I'm trying to find the words. Somebody from Old First, help me out. What was the program at the church where people stayed? Family Promise, thank you. There is a Family Promise. It's to help people who are refugees that are living in the area that need a place to stay. What happens is churches will open their doors and allow people to sleep there. They provide them a meal, and they help them with whatever help that they might need. Obviously, we can't do that here at Good Shepherd because we don't have the facilities to put people up and put up beds and so forth. But Heidelberg does, and they're looking to partner with us to see if we would be willing to join with them to provide meals and provide outreach to these refugees that would be living in our area. If any of you are interested, there's going to be a meeting tomorrow night at 6 o'clock at Heidelberg Church, and that way we can get a format and see what all's there, and we can hopefully get this ministry up and running. Any questions about Family Promise? I hope I can explain it okay. This is an announcement through Karen Smith. Sportsman's Night has been changed to August the 13th, and she does have tickets for sale. If anybody has, because I know that there are people who have been asking about when they would get the tickets, and they have like 20 or 30 sold already. So if you're interested, please see Karen after the service today. I think that's all the announcements I have. Thank you.
You're welcome. Anyone else with an announcement for the congregation? If not, let's prepare our hearts and minds for the worship of God. Thank you.
Thank you. and turn it into possibility.
God has rolled away the bindings of yesterday,
making ordinary things extraordinary.
God calls us out of the tombs we inhabit
into an undreamed tomorrow.
Let us praise God for the risen Christ
in newness and hope of Pentecost. Amen.
Let us join in singing hymn number 249.
Thank you.
Unfortunately, our lecturer was tested positive for COVID, and so she was not able to be here this morning. So you have to listen to my voice again. A reading according to the book of Acts, the second chapter, verses 1 through 21. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind. And it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as a fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deed of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, 'What does this mean?' But others sneered and said, 'They are filled with new wine.' But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, 'Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
Let us pray. Holy and gracious one, speak now to our hearts as we continue to humbly beseech you to change us into the creatures you desire. Creatures that show overwhelming love, forgiveness, and compassion. Help us that we might continue to do your will according to Christ's ways. For this we pray in his precious name, and let the people of God say, amen. I don't know which way to face. I want to talk to you, but it would be rude for me to have my back towards the congregation. But if I face this way, I don't know if you're paying attention or not. So if the congregation would keep an eye on the front and make sure that they're staying awake and alert and they look riveted to everything I have to say. The reason for my wanting to talk to them, as well as all of us, is that this passage in Scripture is unique. And it speaks to us to this day. There are probably about, Amanda, what was the count? 100 people here today?
127.
So there's 127 people here today. 127 people listening to the
words that we read in Scripture and the words I speak to you now, and I can guarantee you there's probably 128 people receiving different messages. You are hearing it for who you are and where you are. Very similar to what was happening in this day of Pentecost 2,000 years ago. These men, all Galileans, are speaking, and the people that are there are hearing it in their own language. They are understanding it according to what they need to get from this, so that they might be blessed by God. And if we listen, we believe that the Holy Spirit is going to be a part of our lives. So even 2,000 years later, when I'm talking to you all, and I'm talking to you all, you're all hearing it differently. Some of you are taking it in and saying, thank God that God is with us and for us. There's others that are going, God, who? And there's others who are angry with God. But God still speaks to each and every individual according to what they need to hear. This is profound. And it makes life difficult as a pastor, as a Sunday school teacher, as a member of the choir, of committed people who serve on various committees, and so forth. It's confounding, especially when we're young, 12, 13, 14 years of age, and we're making a commitment that in the sight of the church, these people behind me are no longer considered children. They are considered adults. And so as adults, you have not only the rights to take communion and to participate, but you also have the responsibilities to take communion and to answer the call to serve in various ways. You're not all going to be on the altar guild. You're not all going to be a faith formation teacher. You're not all going to be dealing with consistory. But some of you will be doing those things so that we might continue to propel the church into the future. And that we might continue to be a blessing to others, just as yourselves have been blessed. Did you all hear that? The same goes for you. We are still called to be the faith, the community of faith of God, and we're continuing to ask to follow the ways of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, so that we might continue to be diligent in what we do here, so that we might create a space that is welcoming, hospitable, a place that is comfortable for people to gather and that they feel, before they even walk through the doors, that they belong. This is my prayer for a good shepherd, for the new members as well as the old members and as well as our friends. I pray that we at Good Shepherd, though many voices, be one in faith. Though many dreams, be one in hope. Though many backgrounds, be one in baptism. Though many disciples, be one in Christ. Through many communities, be one in spirit. May we be one with God, our Father, God, Jesus Christ, and God the Holy Spirit, that we might continue to be a blessing as we have been blessed. This I pray in Jesus' name. Let the people of God say,
Amen.
It is with heavy hearts that we hear the news of Janet Berman's passing. I know that it's a loss, but for her it's a gain. She has been struggling the last few months, and she's been going in and out of assisted livings and hospital, and last evening God received her into God's loving embrace. So we pray for Janet's children and grandchildren as we prepare today for services for her, possibly here at the church, but look for it in the newspapers and keep that family in your prayers. I also ask that you would keep in prayer
prayers, the people that are inside back of your bulletin cover, especially Dorothy Arnold, who's home, continuing to convalesce, for Ann Johnson, who is in rehab now and is doing quite well. I understand Madeline, you and Robin were down to see her. She appreciates the visit, and she's doing very well. And she sends her regards to the whole church community. I would ask that you would keep in prayer Barbara Hanks. Some of you know Barbara Hanks. She was our coach for our Vitality team 2 or 3 years ago. And she has been dealing with some health issues, and she had a procedure on Wednesday. And when they were doing the procedure, they discovered that she is has cancer spread throughout her body. And they brought her home, and she's in hospice care. So for those of you who remember Barbara, if you would keep her and her family in your prayers. Pam Puskas asked for prayers for Michael. Help me out here, Pam.
Ciccarelli.
Okay. And so our prayers would be spared. Let us turn to God and offer God our heartfelt prayers. Let us pray. Gracious One, we gather today to give you thanks and praise for all your blessings. We especially thank you for the young people who have come to affirm their parents' baptismal vows for them when they were but children. We pray that you might continue to give them hearts to sense your presence, eyes to see your good works, ears to hear your comforting words, and the knowledge knowing that you have claimed them as your own. We pray, O gracious One, that you hear our prayers for all those in our community of faith, for those who are struggling to make ends meet, for those who are unemployed. We pray for those who are dealing with addictions, and we also pray for those who are battling depression. We pray that you might continue to help us, that we might hear your call, that people of faithfulness might be responding to your call to service in the humanities. We pray that you might continue to bless those who are serving our country far away as well here at home. We pray that you might hear our prayers for those who are struggling in the hospital, those who are recuperating, for those who are at home convalescing. We pray for our homebound, that they might continue to know just how precious they are and that they still are part of our community of faith and instrumental in that. We pray that you might continue to bless the leaders of our congregation, that they might continue to discern your will for our future, so that we might continue to be held accountable and that we might continue to follow the ways of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. We pray for those of us who continue to learn what it means to be a disciple of Christ, because we are all continuing to learn each and every day. And we pray that you might help us to live as people who believe in your promises found in Jesus Christ, that Jesus goes to prepare a place for each and every one of us. We pray that you might hear our prayers for those who grieve the loss of loved ones, that you might continue to comfort them with the knowledge that their loved ones live on, not just in memories and in thoughts, but they live on with you in a place beyond time and space. We pray that you hear our prayers then, and that you might continue to bless us with all your saints throughout the ages, as you connect us as one body in the spirit of your Son, our Savior Christ, who taught us to pray,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Let us gather our tithes and offerings with joy and laughter.
Amen.
Would you please rise in body or in spirit and join in the singing of our doxology.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God.
love for you and our neighbors. This we pray through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
The congregation may be seated.
The church is a family of people with varieties of gifts united by the Spirit revealed in Jesus of Nazareth.
It is the Spirit of caring for one another, of forgiving others, of helping each other, of sharing love revealed in the life and death of Jesus.
The church is the people of God with a diversity of needs, ideas, and visions inspired by the Spirit praying through the words and deeds of Jesus as recorded in Scripture. May that same Spirit rest upon us.
It is the Spirit of openness to all people, our sisters and brothers, seeking and searching, as with voices together saying, we believe, help our unbelief.
The Spirit of Christ calls us into a life of servanthood unto suffering.
The suffering servant is one who is despised and rejected, a person of sorrows and well acquainted with grief. The suffering servant bears the grief and sorrows of others, and through suffering brings wholeness.
We want to share in the Spirit.
The Spirit of Christ is the Spirit of covenant, formation of community building.
We stand at the end of a cloud of witnesses that include Abraham and Sarah, Miriam and Moses, Esther and David, Job's daughters and sons of prophets, as well as brothers and sisters who stand open into the Spirit's bidding.
We want to share in that Spirit.
The Spirit of Christ is also the ruler of creation.
The Spirit that was creative brooding presence in the midst of the waters of chaos is still moving in our midst and in the midst of the ongoing creation of the world, to bring order out of chaos, unity in the midst of disunity, life in the midst of death.
We want to share in that Spirit.
We invite to come forward those who wish to affirm their baptism by confirming and present them to the community of faith in the hope that the Spirit of Christ might rest upon each of them and all of us together. May the Spirit of the resurrected Christ make us into one body, which is Christ.
Friends in Christ, we are all received into the church through the sacrament of baptism. These people have found nurture and support in our midst here at Good Shepherd, our family in Christ. Through prayer and study, they have been led by the Holy Spirit to affirm their baptism and to claim in our presence their covenantal relationship with Christ and the members of his church. They are here for service to Jesus Christ, using the gifts which the Holy Spirit bestows. God's message is near to you, on your lips and in your hearts. That is the word of faith that we preach. If you confess with your lips that Jesus is Lord and believe that God raised Jesus from the dead, you will be saved. For it is by our faith that we are put right with God. It is by our confession that we are saved. Congregants, you have come that God may claim you publicly for God's service and confirm you in God's covenant and invoke upon you the Holy Spirit, by whose help alone you are able to fulfill your vows. Hear the word of our Lord and of his apostles concerning the gift of the Spirit. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, for he dwells with you and in you. I ask you. you now in the presence of God and this congregation. Do you believe in God, the creator of the universe, who calls us each into relationship with God and with one another? If so, answer, I do. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, who is a revealing expression of God's love, come to dwell among the human family? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit as the force by which we are brought into closer harmony with the will of God? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
Do you then, as persons who have declared your faith before this gathered company, seek to become one in the Spirit with the membership of your Shepherd United Church of Christ? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
In so doing, do you promise to enter an honest and open relationship of mutual support and nurture with this congregation? If so, answer, I promise with the help of God.
I promise with the help of God.
Do you promise to further the work of God's realm and the Church Universal by studying and prayerful efforts to serve all humanity after the manner of Jesus Christ? If so, answer, I promise with the help of God. Finally, do you promise to challenge the limits of your faith through education, prayer, reflection, and examination? If so, answer, I promise with the help of God.
I promise with the help of God.
Turn to face the congregation. I would ask the parents of these congregants to please stand where you are. As parents of these young people who are being confirmed in the church today, you are well aware of the training and planning that has preceded this event. As your children assume the vows of confirmation, they will become official members of our church, which includes the privileges of membership as well as its responsibilities. They cannot continue to fulfill their confirmation vows unless they receive the cooperation and support of you as parents. They will continue to need guidance and direction in their daily living as well as in their church relationship. This must be given not by words alone, but also through the example of Christian living that they will see in you. Will you accept this as your responsibility and pledge your continuing support of your children in this relationship in the presence of Almighty God and this congregation? If so, answer, I will with the grace of God. Would the members of the congregation please rise? And friends. Do you give yourselves to God as God's own through Jesus Christ to love and serve God faithfully all the days of your life? If so, answer, we do.
We do.
Do you promise to love and support these congregants as they promise to participate in the life and mission of this family of God's people, sharing with them in the worship of God and enlisting them in the work of Good Shepherd United Church of Christ as it serves this community and the world? If so, answer, we promise with the help of God.
We promise with the help of God.
Let us join in our prayer for the congregants in unison. Congregants in prayer, please. Almighty God, who in baptism received these your servants into the church, forgave their sins and promised them eternal life, increase in them the gifts of your Holy Spirit, grant love for others, joy in serving you, peace in disagreement, patience in suffering, kindness toward all people, goodness in evil times, faithfulness in temptation, gentleness in the face of opposition, self-control in all things, thereby strengthen them for their ministry in the world, through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. The congregation may be seated. Thank you.
the God of peace, sanctify you wholly, and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Alexander Michael Bablavi. The God of peace, sanctify you wholly, and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Kyan Paul Maurice Block. The God of peace, sanctify you wholly, and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Patrick Henry James Conway. The God of peace, sanctify you wholly, and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Noah John Griffith. The God of peace, sanctify you wholly, and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Haley Faith Zittle. The God of peace, sanctify you wholly, and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Savannah Hope Middle. The God of peace, sanctify you wholly, and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Cecilia Mary Piper. The God of peace, sanctify you wholly, and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Brianna Deborah Richardson. May the God of peace sanctify you wholly and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Jasmine Denise Richardson. The God of peace sanctify you wholly and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Aiden Lucas Holt. The God of peace sanctify you wholly and keep you blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I extend to you the right hand of Christian fellowship and welcome, and we welcome you to participate in the work God sets before us in the world. At this time, I'm going to call upon our faith formation director and our consistory president to also welcome you into the church.
where the night of the disciples gathered in an upper room and sat round the table with Jesus. Everything was ready, all the preparations carefully made.
At the last meal, he took bread, blessed it, and broke it, and after their meal together, he took wine, gave thanks to God, and poured it in the cup. Signs of his love, signs of our forgiveness. Signs by which they and us would be able to remember him.
He asked those who were there that night to keep on meeting together to share, to continue to eat the bread and drink the wine, so that he could weep if they were weeping, and laugh if they were laughing, so he could confirm or comfort and encourage and affirm.
Today we have come to take part in this meal. We have been invited to recognize Christ among us in the broken bread and the wine poured out, that we might find comfort and encouragement and affirmation. Here we receive something that can help us in our striving to do the right thing, something that can make our decision-making a little bit easier, something which can give us strength and inspiration as well as encouragement to keep on the right track in all our living.
Here we receive the gifts of heaven, gifts for the good of us all.
Let us pray. We gather around this table today, Almighty God, to give you thanks. You claim us as your people, bathe us in forgiveness through baptism, and draw us together into your church. You call us to be your royal priesthood, a holy people, and you give us this holy meal as food for our journey. Today, 11 young men and women have confirmed their faith in you through Christ, professing their faith and
your presence in their journey.
Today they claim your gracious love for themselves and seek to live in a deeper and more mature faith. Give them your grace and peace. Now we join together to remember and experience anew the presence of the risen Christ
in our midst at this table. We give thanks for the gracious life of Jesus, teaching and healing, challenging and loving, dying and rising. As we eat this bread and drink of this cup, pour out your Holy Spirit on us, that we may go forth to live as those claimed by you, your holy people, spreading holiness and wholeness in your world this day. To you, O God, be the glory now and forever. Amen.
Merciful God, you recall anew the words and actions of our Lord Jesus Christ. When he took bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave it to the disciples, and said, "This is my body which is broken for you. Take, all of you, and eat of this. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same manner, after having supped, he took the cup of blessing, and after giving thanks, gave it to the disciples, and said, "This is my blood poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. Take all of you and drink from it. Do this in remembrance of me." And we recall Jesus' promise not to drink from the cup of the fruit of the vine again until that heavenly banquet when we would all gather around Christ's table. And so we proclaim what we believe.
Christ is alive. Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit, come. Bless this bread and bless this fruit of the vine. Bless us in our eating and drinking at this table, that our eyes might be opened and we might recognize the risen Christ within ourselves, each other, and all for whom Christ died.
Amen.
Through the broken bread,
we
participate in the body of Christ.
Through the cup of blessing,
we participate in the new life Christ offers.
Oh, Christ, the Lamb of God.
Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. All who come to me will never hunger again, but will live by the righteousness of God. Take, eat, do this in remembrance of Jesus our Lord." Thank you. children in the congregation, please rise. Let me pray this blessing upon you. I pray that the Holy Spirit continue to bless you, and that you might continue to be filled with the goodness and love of God through Jesus Christ, and that you might find comfort and welcome here in our midst, today and always. May you be blessed through the Spirit of Christ. Let the people say,
Amen.
Jesus said, I am the vine, and you are the branches. Through you, my love will reach the farthest ends of the earth. Know that your sins have been washed away in my blood. Take and drink. Do this in remembrance of Christ our King. The congregation, please rise and join me in the prayer of thanksgiving. O God,
when we come together this way in Holy Communion, instead of needing more, we learn to share what we possess with all hurters hungry.
We leave here with grateful hearts for all your gifts which surround us all. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, the way, we find the communion becomes a path that fills our heart with praise, and our inner needs are fed, so that we may go forth as you have called us to serve. In the name of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us join in our final hymn, number 450.
Thank you.
say this, that one of the treasures of the last 2 years with these young people is creating relationships with them, that they get to know me and I get to know them in wonderful and beautiful ways, that they might continue to know that God is present through their pastor and now through you. I pray that you go out and love these young people, in fact, love all God's people, so that they might feel welcome to come here and to affirm their faith in the triune God. And as you go forth to invite others to participate in the life of the body of Christ, take this blessing with you. That the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that the love of God our Heavenly Father, and that the communion of the Holy Spirit go with you now and forevermore. Amen.